I don't know about you, but I am always looking for ways to grow my sales and revenues with insider secrets about Facebook advertising. Now, today I'm going to talk to you about 7 things that you can do to improve the results of your Facebook ads. These are things that I do all the time to improve my click-through rate, to lower my cost per click, and to make sure that I'm sending the right ads to the right people at the right time. Now, if you want to take a super deep dive into this, I'd encourage you to check out my friend Andrea Vall's course. She's got a great course on this, but these are 7 things you can do right away and start applying to your business right now. We're going to cover off on everything from how to do a custom audience to make sure you're zeroing in on the right prospect. We're going to talk about the metrics that you're looking at and why one metric in particular is a secret metric that if you look at the right way, you can start using it to lower your cost per click. And then we're going to wrap up by talking about how to calculate the return on your investment with your Facebook advertising campaign. I was recently out at the Desert Ridge Resort doing a speech to a big room about this very topic, and I covered off on a lot of the things that I'm about to tell you. So let's head out to the Desert Ridge Resort where I talked about this. But first, I want to encourage you to leave a comment below at the end of this. And if you do leave a comment, I will send you a free digital copy of my latest book, Digital Marketing Growth Hacks. It's a book I wrote with 13 world-famous experts who talked about all the things that you can do in order to grow your business using digital marketing. So if you want a free digital copy of that, leave a comment below and I'll be sure to send you one. Now, my name is Jamie Turner and this is In 60, where I talk to you about ways to grow your business or improve your career. Let's head out to Arizona where I talked about Facebook advertising. Let's dive in. First, I want to thank TalkWalker, who's a sponsor for this episode. TalkWalker is an end-to-end social listening and analytics platform that provides real-time monitoring for thousands of brands around the globe. I'm a big fan of their new image recognition technology. Check out TalkWalker when you get a chance. Now, let's dive in. The first thing you probably measure is impressions, reach, and frequency. Of course, impressions are the number of times your ad has been served up. It's kind of a false signal, because you can have a lot of impressions, but an ad that actually isn't performing all that well. The second thing you're probably measuring is reach. That's the number of unique times your ad has been served to an individual. That tells you basically how many people have seen your ad. But the third thing that you're looking at, but you're probably not realizing is one of the more important things, is frequency. Why is frequency important? Well, here's why. Ad Espresso did an analysis where they figured out the click-through rate over time decreases on any given ad the more frequently you show it. Part of this is due to banner blindness. People see the ad, they're tired of it, they've seen it before. If you don't refresh that ad, they stop clicking through on the ad. Now, here's what's even more fascinating. As the click-through rate decreases, the cost per click increases. Puh! Wait a second, man, that's horrible. That means fewer people are clicking your ads. And when they do, you're getting charged even more because Facebook doesn't think people like the ads anymore. So that's an important thing to keep in mind, that as your click-through rate decreases, your cost per click increases. In fact, at a frequency of 9, the average cost per click increased 161%. I'm not kidding you, 161%. I am serious. So the key thing that you need to learn here is that you have to refresh your ad, because by the 9th time that ad is seen by somebody, it is costing you 161% more than the first time they saw it. So remember, refresh your creative so that your click-through rate stays high. The higher your click-through rate, the lower your cost per click. That's an important thing that I want to have you remember coming out of this. That's a really critical thing. So keep that in mind, folks, because that's important. Well, here's another tip for you. You can create a custom audience from a customer file. What does that mean? Well, if you're like most people, you collect email addresses of people who have either bought your product or service or who are engaged with your brand. If that's the case, then you need to take that data and information and upload it to Facebook so you can create a custom audience. That means that you can then target those people who have visited your site, who are part of your database, who have gone in and already expressed an interest in your product or service, and start targeting them. Now, here's what's cool. There's 2 things you need to do with that. Number one, you can target those people to try to loop them back in to buy more of your products or services, or you can not target those people in case you're saying, those are people who already know about my product or service. I'm going over here to get people who don't know about my product or service. Now, let me tell you a little trick here. The number one place you can get new revenue is not from people who haven't bought your product or service before, but it's from people who have bought your product or service before. That's a little tip that a lot of people don't realize. Your best source of new revenue is to get existing customers to buy more frequently. So if you create a custom audience, you can then go in and instead of having somebody buy your product or service once every month, you can get them to buy twice a month. That doubles your revenue from those people. That's a terrific tip that you gotta keep in mind moving forward. Here's another tip for you. You can take your custom audience and create a lookalike audience of people around the country who look like your customers already. That's a great way to start targeting people who have a propensity to buy your product or service. So remember to do that, create a custom audience, then create a lookalike audience from that custom audience so that you can go out and start targeting those people more effectively with better ads that have a better click-through rate, a better return on your investment. Hey, don't forget, we're gonna talk about how to calculate your return on investment in a second, but we're gonna get there. But remember, create a custom audience, then create a lookalike audience, and that'll improve the results of your campaign. Now, here's another tip for you. This is an insider tip. You can do research on what your competitors are running in their Facebook ads. What? Yeah, you can find out exactly what your competitors are doing with their Facebook ads. Why is this such a big deal? Because they've already made a ton of mistakes for you. You don't have to make the same mistakes they've made because you can look at what they're doing, compare what they're doing to what you're about to do, and then improve the results of your campaigns by borrowing, otherwise known as stealing, their ideas for your own stuff. Now, keep that in mind. Check out what your competitors are doing. And if you do that, you're going to be able to improve the results of your campaigns because they've already made the mistakes for you. Let's keep going. Here's another tip. You can create a retargeting campaign on Facebook relatively easily. How? Hey, first of all, you got to drop a pixel, a Facebook pixel, onto your website. It's not as hard as it sounds, but take care of that first. Once you've got that pixel in there, and by the way, of course, a pixel is just a way for your website to tell that browser, hey, that person is visiting my website. Now I've got that data and I can track that data and figure out how to remarket to people. Remarketing, of course, is taking somebody who's visited your website and then when they go off to another website, targeting ads to them, or when they go off to Facebook, targeting your Facebook ads to them because you know they visited your website, which shows an interest in your product or service. So make sure you add a Facebook pixel, then choose an option. Do you wanna target the people who visited your site, targeted people who viewed a landing page but didn't buy on your site, or cross-sell products? That's a great one. If they've already bought a product, hey, you bought the t-shirt in blue, we want to sell one to you in red, or we want to sell you a green t-shirt. Either way, you can start using that as a terrific way in order to retarget people and do that. Now, a couple of final tips for you. You got to run an A-B split test in order to optimize your campaign. An A-B split test is where you take an A version, otherwise known as the control, run that ad, find out the results from that ad in terms of click-through rate, in terms of impressions, in terms of all sorts of different metrics, and then test one variable on that same ad for your B version. A is the control, B is testing a variable. That might be a different headline, it might be a different graphic, it might be a different call to action, it might be a different copy, it doesn't matter, but you test that one variable. When you've done that, then you can go in and start figuring out which one of those ads is better. Once you have that answer, that's your new control. In other words, if you tested A and then you tested B against it and found out that B performed better, this is now your new control and you start testing against the new control. When you do that, you're able to optimize your ad campaigns and slowly build up and make better and better results for your ad campaigns. Why is this important? Here's why. Take a look at this video. This is video of a Formula One race car in 1950 pulling in and getting their four tires changed. In 1950, it took 67 seconds to change four tires on a Formula One race car. Ultimately, what they did was they improved that over the course of time by doing something called stacking. Stacking is where you make little incremental improvements over the course of time, and ultimately you can improve the results of your campaigns dramatically. What happened in terms of the Formula One race car? Here's what happened. They changed it so that they can now change the tires, all four of them, mind you, in 2.7 seconds. Boop, car comes in, boop, car goes out. Used to take 67 seconds, now it takes 2.7 seconds. That's called optimization, and it's what you wanna do with your A-B split testing all along. You wanna keep improving the results of your campaigns. Over the course of time, you're gonna find out that you've got much, much better results. Now, let's keep going on this, because we are on a roll here. All right, our next tip for you is about customer lifetime value. It's an important calculation that can help you figure out whether or not you're making a positive return on your investment with Facebook advertising. And it all starts with customer lifetime value. What is customer lifetime value? In its simplest form, it's the amount of revenue you generate on a per customer basis during the course of their engagement with your brand. So let's say you're a lawn care company and you go out and you have $100 a month for your lawn care service. You can go in and have your average customer stay with you for 24 months. If they stay with you for 24 months, then the customer lifetime value during that 24-month period is $2,400. $100 a month times 24 months is the average lifetime of a customer, and so that gives you $2,400. The reason that's important is because it helps you understand the value of a customer. Every time you get a new customer, on average, you know that you're gonna make in revenue about $2,400 from them. That's pretty good. Well, now you have to figure out what your allowable cost per sale is for that customer. And what that means is you've got to figure out how much would I allow myself to spend in order to acquire a new customer. And that, generally speaking, you can start out with about 10% of your customer lifetime value. So if you're a lawn care company and you have $100 a month is what you charge for your service, and your average customer stays with you for 24 months, you know that your customer lifetime value is $2,400, your allowable cost per sale is 10% of that, which means you can spend $240 in order to acquire that customer. So the $240 to acquire a customer may sound like a lot of money, but it's actually not that much, because remember, you've got to drive a lot of people to your website before you convert one of them into a customer. You may have to drive 100, 500, 1,000 people to your website before one of them becomes a customer. So you have to use that calculation and figure out how much does it cost me using Facebook advertising to drive somebody to my website, and what percentage of those people convert to become customers at the end of that sales funnel. If you drive 1,000 people to your website and you convert one of them, and it costs you $240 in order to drive those 1,000 people to your website, and you converted one of them, you basically have a pretty good handle on how you can use Facebook advertising in order to drive people to your website and convert them into customers. But remember, if you can get those customers there and convert it for $120 per sale, then suddenly you're really doing well, because you're figuring out all the things that you need to do in order to get more customers to your website and convert more of them into customers. Bottom line is, you have to start out by understanding customer lifetime value, then you have to understand your allowable cost per sale, and then you have to use that money in order to drive a bunch of people into the top of the funnel. When you get one customer out at the bottom of the funnel who becomes a customer, and you've done it for $120 or $60 or $240 in worst case scenario, then you know that you've got basically a positive ROI. Now, that is an overly simple version of using customer lifetime value in order to figure out if you have a positive ROI. There are a lot more complex ways to do it that are more nuanced, but if you use that kind of as the fundamental starting point, then you'll be able to figure out whether or not your Facebook advertising campaign is generating a positive ROI. Hey, we covered a lot of ground today. Let's do a quick recap of everything that we've talked about, because there's been a lot of ground that we've covered. All of these tips are important. Remember, the key thing is, it's one thing to know something, it's another thing to actually take action on it. So be sure to put these action steps into work for your business. We talked about impressions, reach, and frequency, and we talked about how Ad Espresso did their study, which found that at a frequency of 9, the average cost per click increases 161%. That's big information. So make sure to refresh your ads as you move through things. We then talked about creating a custom audience from a customer file. We all have customer files, but here's a little pro bonus tip for you, which is, when you have a customer file, figure out who your most profitable customers are, and then create a custom audience based on your most profitable customers. Not just any customer, but your most profitable ones. Once you've done that, go in and create a lookalike audience in Facebook that looks like those most profitable customers. That's a hidden pro tip that you can use in order to make sure that what you're doing on Facebook is giving you the most bang for your buck. We then talked about doing research on your
competitors and going to their Facebook page and selecting the info and ad section, and you'll get tons of information about what your competitors are doing. Remember, they've already made a bunch of mistakes. You can learn from their mistakes. From there, we went on and talked about creating a retargeting campaign that involves adding a Facebook pixel. That's important, but it's not that hard to do. Once you've done that, you'll find that your Facebook campaigns can start being retargeted to people who visited your website previously. From there, we talked about running an A/B split test to optimize your campaign and the importance of that. We talked about how to calculate your return on investment, because if you understand customer lifetime value and your allowable cost per acquisition, then you can all of a sudden understand whether or not you're generating a positive ROI with your Facebook campaigns. All right, we've covered a lot of ground in today's episode. Before we go, I want you to do one thing for me. Go down to the comments section below. Leave your favorite Facebook advertising hack down below, because the community would love to hear from you about what you're doing to improve your Facebook advertising results. My name is Jamie Turner. This has been In 60. I'm coming to you live, well, not live really, but I'm coming to you from the Desert Ridge Resort here in beautiful Arizona, where I just got off stage. I want to thank our sponsor for today's episode, TalkWalker. They're doing a great job supporting us. Make sure to leave a comment, make sure to give us a thumbs up, and make sure to hit the subscribe button, because there will be more episodes like this coming down the pike. My name is Jamie Turner. This has been In 60, and I will catch you next time.
Hey, quick follow-up for you. First of all, I just want to acknowledge the fact that these are not ending up turning out to be 60 seconds. We were trying to do 60 seconds to begin with, and then maybe 3 or 4 minutes after that. It all got messed up, so it didn't turn out to be in 60 seconds, but hey, whatever. Second thing is, I want to let you know, if you're one of the first 5 people to make a comment down below, I will give you a free digital copy of Digital Marketing Growth Hacks, the book I wrote with 13 other of the world's best digital marketers. We all got together, put together some ideas on how to improve your digital marketing skills. The people range from Eric Qualman to Dave Kirpin to Andre Vall, all people that you've heard of. Ian Cleary is in there, Emeric Arnault is in there, all these people who are absolutely fabulous. And we put together the book. If you were one of the 5 people to make a comment, one of the first 5 people to make a comment down below, I will give you a free digital copy of it. Or if you click the affiliate link down below and buy it on Amazon for $9.99, 100% of the revenue goes to charity. So be sure to click the affiliate link if you want to buy it and donate the money to charity. It's a great book, tons of digital growth marketing hacks in there that you can use in order to grow your sales and revenues. My name is Jamie Turner. This has been In 60, not really In 60, but you know what I mean. I'll catch you next time.